John, I have to admit, this is pretty impressive.
So we're looking at the brown rock here, which is the core of the Uinta Mountains. And we're looking at the tan rock up there, which is the Madison limestone. It's the same limestone that we see in Grand Canyon that we call the Redwall limestone there.
Okay. Uh-huh.
The same kind of thing is happening here that happened in Carbon Canyon at the same time.
So the folding that we saw in Carbon Canyon, which doesn't seem to be nearly as massive as this, but it was the same kind of principle, right?
Here. Yeah. So this entire area is getting lifted up. And especially here in the mountain ranges, as it gets lifted up, some of the Precambrian rocks are going to break. But they have soft sediments that are sitting on top of them.
Uh-huh.
And so as the mountains lift up, the soft Paleozoic sediments get deformed. And that's that big bend that we're seeing in the rocks.
And it just folds. It's apparent to me when I'm looking at it that this was soft when all of that happened. Even in the vertical side here, we see some bending and folding.
Right.
John, also the thing that strikes me, I mean, we saw this layer in the Grand Canyon. I don't know how far away that is. It's a long ways away.
All the way across the state of Utah.
Right. But there are mountains in between there.
Uh-huh.
And you couldn't get those nice flat layers if those mountains were there. So it's obvious the layers were laid down, the mountains were then pushed up, and because they were soft, then they folded instead of broke and were brittle like we see underneath.
Yeah, so that's correct, Del. All these layers in the Paleozoic and the Mesozoic rocks that we're talking about here, these had to be laid down before these mountains are pushed up, because those are the layers that are deformed by the mountains rising.
Yeah. You see these all over the earth, do you not?
Yeah, you do. You see some other big folds like this in places like the Alps, the Appalachian Mountains, and things like that. And again, it's the same argument that these rocks are bending because they're soft.
Mm-hmm.
They haven't hardened yet. The hardening takes place after the bending.